Okay, holidays are over. We're back to our usual Wednesday night class. It is October 22nd, 2014. We're going to be reading a teshubah from Rabbi Moshe Malka, who was the chief rabbi of Petah Tikva. This is a teshubah he wrote in 1980. Lady Dinwayakar, Harab Kulil bi Israel. He won money on Rab Yaakov Halevi Shalita. Yidid Yakar, Kibbati et Mechtabecha Zemano Kabbet Nisan Tasham. Shevoa Tashuel, Madu wa lo naqeta mu'ashid Rabbanut Harashit Yuzma, Vehashvot min hakeha idot Hashonot Nimsaim Ba'aris Minahim. So he's saying that this Rabbi Yaakov Levi wrote a series of questions to Rabbi Moshe Malka. And he asked him, Rabbi, I don't understand. How come the chief rabbinate, okay, hasn't gotten together and tried to form some sort of equivalency between the different communities, you know, throughout Israel? Why do we still have all these differences? How come the chief rabbinate is not doing anything to to unify the people? لما لو هيخريزا المنهج احد هالشافية لخول ازراحية مدينة ما نوسع حابة في اللوت. How come it has not declared one منهج that is to be used by all, what do you call it, all citizens of the state, and one نوسح, one format of تفيلة for everybody. כך נגיע למיזוג גדויות ולא תהיינה עוד Therefore, we can bring together all the different people from different aspects of the diaspora, and we do not have separate communities anymore. Ashkenaziyot lebad, Sephardiyot lebad. We won't have Ashkenazim by themselves, Sephardim by themselves. Shekin, shinui haminhagim vehatifilot menasihim etapirud vehapilug benhaidot. Because what happens is when you upkeep these separate minhagim and separate forms of prayer, who's the winner? The winner is discord. Discord wins out. You're keeping the people separate and you're keeping, you know, classes and sects instead of bringing the nation together. Gam minui shirei rabbanim bechol ayir. And the appointment of two rabbis to every city, אחד אשכנזי ואחד ספרדי, תורים לכך, ולמה לא יהיה רק רב אחד? And also having in every city throughout Israel, every city has a Ashkenazi chief rabbi and a Sephardi chief rabbi. Again, it's promoting this galut mentality that, because really we were Am Yisrael, we came from one nation, and because we were exiled and then exiled from place to place, you know, it's not that Borei Olam or Am Yisrael made themselves a separate people. We were one people originally. And only because of the exiles to different portions, different corners of the earth, did we become Ashkenazim, Sephardim, Temanim, Italkim, Bablim, whatever the case may be. It's not who Am Yisrael is, okay? Am Yisrael should be one nation. And by, you know, you're upkeeping two separate rabbis, different minhagim, different tefillot. What are you doing? You know, we're all so happy that we're having the incoming of, you know, of the exiles, but we're doing nothing about it. So, very good questions, I think. And we're going to get to the answer now. The reason I thought this was an appropriate thing to do, because it's a great topic, that's number one. And number two, as I mentioned in the brief email, yesterday they finally had the elections for Chief Rabbi of Jerusalem. There hasn't been a Chief Rabbi in Jerusalem since 2003 when both the Ashkenazi and Sephardi rabbis passed away. And once again, we have an Ashkenazi and Sephardi Chief Rabbi of Jerusalem. Are they going to work together, not work together? How's it going to help the city? Let's wait and see. Teshuvah. שאלה גדולה ידידי שאלת. That's a great question. Unbelievable question. אך את פתרונה לא יוכל לבוא על ידי יחיד, بلو عيدي يحيدين جملو عيدي معايز ربانوت. Great question. The answer can't come from one guy. The answer can't come from a group of people. The answer can't even come from the chief rabbinate itself. כי היא שאלה כוללת ועולמית הנוגעת לכלל היהדות. This is a question that pertains to worldwide Judaism. וצריך שכולם יסכימו לפתרונה. And everybody has to agree to the solution. עם עלייתי לארץ, saying himself, when I made עליית ישראל, הסתתי שאלה זו מעל במה סיבורית. I posed the same question in a public forum. בכנס עולמי של גבאי ביתי כנסת שנתקיים בהיכל שלמה, in a worldwide gathering of גבאים of synagogues that occurred in היכל שלמה. אחרי השעה נדחית על ידי הרב הגאון, הרב הראשי, כבוד מורנו הרב אונטרמן, זכר צדיק לברכה, מתוך נימוק הנזכר לעיל. But whatever I put forward was pushed aside by the chief rabbi at the time, Rabbi Unterman, basically because of what I just said above. It's not up to one person to decide. It's not even up to the chief rabbi to decide. All world Jewry has to, you know, agree on what to do. ואומנם, מה שטענת, but your case over here, your point, you're making a case that we have a problem now. כי שינוי המנהגים והנוסחאות השונות פוגע באחדות האומה, זה לא נכון. You're saying that having separate menhagim, separate styles of praying, basically puts a blemish on the unity of the nation? Sorry, you're incorrect. לא שינוי המנהגים ולא שינוי הנוסחאות פוגע באחדות האומה, אלא היחס השלילי לאמונת השם. What brings the, what keeps the people separate and what stops them from uniting? The negative attitude to faith in God. That's the problem. והביטול והזלזול בערכי הדת ובמסורת האבות. And the abandoning and the belittling in the stature of the religion and in the tradition of our fathers. הם הפוגעים קשה באיחוד העם. These are the main points that hurt the unity of our nation. אילו היה העם מתייחס בחיוב למסורת אבותיו ולערכיהם הנצחיים. If the people as a nation were saying, they related to this obligation to stick to their father's traditions, and they realized its eternal value, לא היה מכבד את תורת השם ומקיים את אבותיה, if it would continue to honor the Torah of Hashem and to upkeep the laws, אז הייתה התורה מאחדת אותו על כל עדותיו ומפלגותיו לחטיבה אחת ויחידה. Then the Torah itself would unite everybody, unite all the different parties, unite all the different groups, unite all the different communities into one solid group. ולא שום שינוי כלשהו. And there wouldn't be any problem whatsoever. ולא כל גורם אחד מבחוץ ומבפנים לא היה יכול לפגוע באחדותו ובייחודו. And no outside source and no inner source would be able to break this apart and to destroy or even put a blemish upon the uniqueness of the unity of Am Hashem, of Am Yisrael. היו מקרים שנקלע יהודי רוסי או פולני למורוקו, והוא משונה בשורת פניו, בלבושו, באופיו, תכונותיו, אין איש יודע מה הוא סך, ואין הוא מבין מה מדברים אליו. ובכל זאת, אם יצליח להוכיח את יהדותו, מתקבל באהבה ואחווה. וזוכה לאשל כאחד מהאחים. يخولو تا مش نو ييم حي سونييم انا مش ريم تياحس الى كلال خور كتابتي كول زي بسفري مقبها مايم حلق باب سمان يدزين رئيشام because there were places where for whatever reason a Russian Jew or a Polish Jew ended up finding his way to Morocco. And did he look like us? No, he looked different. His face was different. His clothing was different. His characteristics were different. The way he walked, the way he talked, the language he spoke, nobody understood him. He didn't understand anybody else. But if he was able to prove that he was Jewish, people accepted him with open arms. And they gave him and treated him like any other Jew. And all these external differences immediately disappeared.
Mm-hmm.
So keep that in mind. And I already wrote about this in another one of my books, he tells you. تدع لخا شبعري مروكو بعصمان كيمين شنويم عصومين مرحيكين ليخت بين إيشيها عام بأوفايم بتخونوتهم بدبورام لفدافك شنويم بين عريونيين إلا قام بين أنشيها عيل بين مشبحوت الشنوت وتودي بين مدينة بيوت إيروبا كو مدينة ومنهيجيها بخل عري بخل عير وأوفيها بتبعها لو رئي زيك رئي زيك بخل زوت الشام يهودي بهدات يهوديت ما حادت اتكلام به إمونا بلوهي إسرائيل من الخيدت أتام لحتيبة أحدش كلام نكرايم يهوديم. He goes, keep in mind, Morocco, big country, lots of Jews. And there were so many differences between Jew to Jew over there. Now, I'm not the one talking about between Jews from one city to another city, but within the same city itself. Between Jews of different families. High class, low class, those that were affected by Europe, those that weren't affected by Europe, you know. But bottom line is, push came to shove, the name Jew is what kept people united and together. It's what was basically the glue that brought the people together. And this, and Jew meant what? It meant emuna. It meant faith in Borei Olam. And that brought the people together as one group. بحماش بكودين من الصحاح التورا هفرادا برشيباطيم كل شبت وميكومو بدقلو ومسبار أنا شاب من الشيات الشيلة مدوة مدقيشها التورا هفرادا زو بأمرا إيش قد دقلو لبيت أبوتا ميحانو بني إسرائيل. Okay, we learn حماش بكودين we learn The Torah talks about the separation between the different tribes. Every tribe and where it was and its flag and the amount of people. And then we ask the question, why is the Torah, you know, making such a point to emphasize and point out this differentiation between the people? Why does it say, Ish al diglo lebet abotav yahanu bin Yisrael? Velama lo yahanu kulam ki yahanu makom ahad tahad digil ahad. Why shouldn't they all live together? You know, all mixed together wherever they want under one flag. Why do they have to 12 separate flags and living separately? When they were back before Yitzhak Mitzrayim, when they were under slavery in Egypt, we never heard anything about different Shevatim. We didn't hear about them being separate. Kulam, Anu. Kulam, Shilmu, Misim. Kulam, Anu. Kulam, Shilmu, Misim. Kulam, Shu'abedu. تحت علوها كبير של שליט מצרים. פירט לשבט לוי, לדעת חזן, פני יומה, לא דאג משה לאחד את כולם תחת דגל אחד. Because they were in Egypt, and they were all caused to suffer. Everybody. They all had to pay tax. They were all enslaved and put to work under the heavy burden of the ruler of Egypt. Except for the tribe of Levi, according to the Hachamim. And for whatever reason, Moshe did not see to it to worry about uniting the people at all. Correct? We don't hear about Moshe doing anything. Ka'amur, lo ha'lebush, v'lo ha'minhag, po'alim ni'yichud ha'am. It's not the clothing and not the minhag that work to unite the people. Gam lo ha'dege, v'lo ha'mikum, gormim ta'yichud. and it's not the flag and not their place that, you know, promotes unity. Illa haddad va'imuna. It's all about religion and faith. Him ha'kub'in. That's what establishes it all. Kisha amdu Yisrael ahar Sinai lekabel ha'Torah. Ne'emar sham. Ve'yihan sham Yisrael neged ha'har. Okay? Perush Rashi. Belev ehad ki ish ehad. Right, you tell me, oh, Ben Yisrael, standing there by Har Sinai, they're there, ready to accept the Torah. You would say, you would think it would say, in plural form, that Vayihanu, okay, Sham Yisrael neged ahar. Ben Yisrael would, were all the people that were encamping together, there, facing the mountain. But it says Vayihan, as one, in the singular form. And as she said, because they were of one heart, like one person. ואז פנה אליהם ברך שמו אנוכי אדוני אלוהיך again בלשון יחיד I am your God. He spoke to them also in the plural. He didn't say אני אדוני אלוהיכם. He said אני אדוני אלוהיך. I am your God. בלשון יחיד שכן התורה יחידה אותם לאומה אחת. התורה that moment united them into one nation. ושם כראה ממלכת כהנים וגוי קדוש שם נסתוו לעשות משכן אחד תוכה ארון העדות אחד. זהו הדבר המאחד את אישי האומה להיות לעם אחד. Right? So even though you had separate encampments for each tribe, there was still only one Mishkan. And in the one Mishkan, one tabernacle, you had one what? One ארון העדות. One closet, if you will. Okay? One hechal. And in there you had one one sefer, it's one sefer, it's one luchot ha-berit, it's one set of Ten Commandments. You didn't have separate ones because it's, again, it's the religion that brings the people together. V'sham kira'am lechet kohanim yugadol, sham mistavu la'asum mishkan echad, tocho aron ha'aydu echad, zehu ha-dabar ha-me'ahed et ishe ha-umah liyot la'am echad. Bihiyotam sabib le'ohon mo'ayd yahanu, omnam kedah shekol echad mehim yakir et horav u'bin mishpachto. And even though you're one, you still have to know who you are and where you came from. Who your parents are and who your family is. יכבד את מסורת אבותיו. Because that's the only way you will honor the tradition of your forefathers. ומנהגיה and its traditions. איש על דגלו לבית אבותיו יחנו בני ישראל. Each person encamps based upon his father's flag within the nation. אך סביב לאול מועד יחנו. But all in all, they were all encamped around the אוהל מועד. כשיחנו סביב סביב לאוהל מועד, כשיקיפו את אוהל מועד שבו נתונים לוחות התורה. Because bottom line is, their focus was in this one circular form, they could see the, if you want to call it, the Mishkan from any place they turned, they knew where it was, and they knew that was the uniting force. That's where the religion was, that's where the Torah was. מארבע רוחותיו, from all four directions. זהו הדבר היחיד המסוגל לאחדם, לחדם לאומה אחת, סביב לאוהל מועד, רק התורה מונחת באוהל מועד, בכוחה להביאם לידי איחוד ואחדות. This is the only thing. So once we know, if once we follow the Torah, if all of Am Yisrael, like you opened up with Rabbi Malka, then if everybody is following the Torah, and everybody, you know, upkeeps and cherishes the tradition of their forefathers, then bottom line is, you don't have, you know, division within the ranks. Bottom line is, everybody's united. Because bottom line, we're all focused on the same thing. We're all focused on Torah. Torah aha, am ahad, that's it. We're all done. Very simple.
Okay.
He's not done. Moshe kibbel, Mishvili Yisrael Torah Mishinai. We read the Pirkei Avot, we say Moshe kibbel Torah Mishinai.
Right.
He didn't just accept the Torah at Sinai. Moshe kibbel bishvil Yisrael. He accepted it on behalf of Israel, for Israel. He accepted the Torah at Sinai. Limeda lehem. He taught it to them. Sima b'fihem. He put it into their mouths. Siva otam neshmor ala kesher ha'abahi v'mishpachti. He showed them how to watch over and observe that connection from father to family. Ish al diglo lebet avotav. אך מנגד לאוהל מועד יחנו. But bottom line is they all encamped facing the אוהל מועד. נוכחתם בקרבתם סביב לאוהל מועד, אוהל שבו שני לוחות הברית מונחים שם, מחזקים את איחודם וליכודם לאומה אחת. Placing them all around the אוהל מועד, where the شيل له حوتة بريد وار. That is what strengthened the people into remaining united as one. موبان مي إلاف شيء ميسر بيرو ذا بيلوغ هشتلت علينو في هو ليخ من قبيب بتوخينو إمرك شيه السن آبه كن معفع مبعبعين بكربينو لو بهبدليها من هجيم يسودام بلو ما حماش نويت في لو بريبوه نسعوت نبعين إلا بنيش أوتو حومرها مدبك فهم ملاخل إشيه أما لقوف إحاد أوتو دبك معحيد سعيدوت بكهلوت لأما أحاد بأشي نبرا من الختحلال لما الترازو نفسال بعينيه مودرنزيم تتحيل كيرن زفيت وبمكومو مشتمشين بطيح ملاخوتي متوسيت يابان عادينا مع سيدي بصر بدام شيلو محزيك مع عماد أفلول شعاع حات. Bottom line is telling you, and he's using beautiful way of saying it, saying it's very, very simple to understand. If all of a sudden you're seeing division and separation is coming between us, and it's getting stronger and growing, and there is more hatred and jealousy that is growing and blossoming and blooming among us, okay? It's not because of differences of minhagim that this is coming from. Who are you lying to? And go, it's not come because, you know, this guy prays different from this guy, and this guy prays different from that. Because who are you kidding to? That's not where it comes from. If everybody was praying, everybody would be happy. Because why? It's that material that was caused to bond us, the glue that's supposed to hold us together and make us into one nation, into one body. This glue is being taken and misused. And instead of looking to the Torah, and following the Torah, and following our Masorah, following what has been taught to us from generation to generation, and to keep cherishing it and passing it on. Nah, now we took it, now we threw it to some corner over there. We don't need it anymore. We have no modern things, nicer. Who needs this old scroll? What do we need it for? Now we have modern technology, we can make much more beautiful things, nicer books, nicer ideas. You know, a new religion, without religion, okay? Things that are in today, and they're gone tomorrow. Nobody's able to create something that's eternal like the Torah. V'lo od, illa shebimkom, sheyehaber v'yelachet, hu mafrid u'marhik. And all the new things people create only causes more and more hatred and division. Because it's all about my way is better than your way, and then the next guy comes and no, my way is better than your way, you're wrong because of this, you're wrong because of that, let's make different things, I'm a Democrat, you're a Republican, I'm a socialist, I'm a communist, I'm an atheist, I'm a Marxist, you know, he goes on and on. لخين قبرها محلوكت مثلتيت. All of a sudden you have so many different parties fighting with each other. بسنعة عدتيت, and you have hatred between communities. هم بليطاء أتام الشنويم حيسونيم شعليهم أتو مدبير. And they use these true reasons to showcase what they're calling religious reasons of hatred, of prayer and منهاج, etc. فخول أحد رؤي بحبرو إزار. And everybody starts looking at each other, not as my fellow Jew, but as a stranger. كلو يهودي, no, he's not Jewish. He's Russian, he's Polish, he's Moroccan, he's Iraqi, etc., etc. So this is what's ruining everything. בימים ההם, כאשר כמעט כולנו היינו מבאי בתי הכנסת, הבית היה מאחד כולנו. אמנם אלה התפללו נוסח אשכנזי ואלה נוסח ספרדי, אלה קראו אזהרות ואלה הקדמות. אך הכל היה הוגה אל מול אלוה איחה ויחיד אל חי מלך מלכים מלכים הקדוש ברוך הוא. هم شايفين متحدين كل تفلوب وكل بكشوت عم شنو يهم نشحط هم من عصيم الطرا بروش حي عالمين. Because bottom line, what it used to be, every Jew used to go to Bet Knesset, used to go to the synagogue. And that synagogue was the place that united the people. It didn't make a difference if you prayed Nosach Ashkenazi or Nosach Sefaradi. If you were Sefaradi and on Shavuot and you read Azharot, you were Ashkenazi on Shavuot and you read Adamot. Okay? Bottom line is, everything was focused towards Borei Olam. And bottom line is, no matter how you prayed and whatever minhag or nosach you went, everything got up to the Shamayim. And in the Shamayim, they knew how to interpret it and understand it properly. And there was no problem. And all our prayers, whether you were Ashkenazi or Sephardi, everything became a crown for Borei Olam. ובזמן הזה, כאשר רוב רובו של העם מוניע רגליו מבית אלוהים. Nowadays, when most Jews never enter the Bet Knesset, ופירט לקומץ קטן מבקר שם, and only a small few visit the synagogue once in a while, השאר פונה כל אחד לבשעו. Everybody else is concerned with בשעו. I'm concerned with my finances. I'm concerned about myself. I'm not concerned with anything else. ורוב בתי כנסת ריקים מאדם, and most synagogues are empty, or mostly empty. לכן, אין לפלא אם יש על הפירוד והפילוג הולך ומתגבר. That being the case, you shouldn't be surprised that there's more and more dissension. There's more and more fights, there's more and more, you know, cliques outside of Judaism. אשר לשאלתך השנייה, שכדאי לבנות רב עיר אחד ולא שני רבנים. Regarding your second question, where you said, you know, we should appoint just one rabbi to the city, not two rabbis. לפי דעתי, אין במינוי שני רבנים שום פגם ולא שום דופי. It makes no difference. One rabbi, two rabbis, what's the difference? עד רבה, זוהי מזוות תורה. שופטים תיתן לך לשבטיך. Okay, you need to have judges. You can't have just one judge. You can't be just one שופט. פרש ראשי זל, לשבטיך, לכל שבט ושבט. Okay, when over there in דברים, in פרשת שופטים, right? שופטים ושוטרים תיתן לך בכל שעריך, right? So, ראשי says, לשבטיך, for your שבטים. Each and every שבט needs to have. So, if we have different שבטים, now we have אשכנזים and ספרדים, so then we need to have it. וכן כתב אבן עזרא, וכן מוחה בגמרא, מנין נוצר הדין לכל שבט ושבט, תראו, תמוד לומר שופטים, לשבטיך. פירות זאת רפות שנה דבור לבנכן שופטים. אם יש בעיר אחת משני שבטים עושים שני סנהדריות. הרמב״ם אמנם בפרק ראשון מלכות מלכות סנהדרין כתב מזוות עשה של תורה למנות שופטים ושוטרים בכל מדינה בכל פלך ולא הזכיר הד לכל שבט ושבט. והכסף משנה תפס עליו. למה השמיט את זה? והוא גמרא ערוכה. גם הלחם משנה כשעליו. שערי פרק ראשון הלכה כתב להדיא. נאכול שבט ושבט. וכתב לתרש דהיינו הך. כאן קרא לפלך ושם שבט. ואולי מפני שכל ישראל התחלקה לשבטים וכל שבט נטל חלק מסוים. לכן נקט פלך במקום שבט. דהיינו הך. במקום שהיו שני שבטים בפלח אחד, יהיה צריך למנות שני שופטים ושני שבטים. כמו שכתב התוספות שם, וכן כתב הרמב"ן על התורה. וכל זה מבואר בדברי הכתוב עצמו, וישפטו את העם משפט צדק. זאת אומרת, כאשר יהיו שופטים מכל שבט ושבט, שכל שבט ידון את שבטו. אז יהיה משפט צדק בהחלט. כי השופט יודע מבין היטב את אנשי שבטו, את אופיים ואת תכונותיהם ומנהגם ואת מסורת אבותיהם וישפוט אותם לפיהם וגם הנפשטים בעצמם יהיו משוכנעים שישפטו בסדק ולא יהיה שום חשש ולא שום חשד על שום נטייה שבטית או מגמתית. So the bulk of this paragraph he's just going into the semantics of how Rashid looks at it, how Ibn Azra looks at it, how the Tosafot look at it, and then he gets into Harambam and how the case of Mishneh and the Leha Mishneh ask questions on the Rambam and how he, why does he use different wording from everybody else and he doesn't really follow the Gemara the way the others see the Gemara. And bottom line is, it makes no difference, he's telling you, because bottom line, everybody comes down to the same idea that each Shevet, each group of people needs to have their own judges, their own people leading them, their own people teaching them, their own, you know, achamim or shofetim, either way it may be. Because if you have a shofet, that doesn't understand your mindset, doesn't understand your tradition from father to son within the, its own Shevet. Let's say you're all from Shevet Dan and you're bringing a guy from Shevet Gad. He doesn't understand your tradition, your family tradition, the makeup of how people from Dan do things. So the people are going to feel that they're not getting, you know, a fair judgment or a fair leader because he doesn't know their mindset. He doesn't know their things. That's what each Shevet would have to have the same thing. The same thing, Sefer Adim and Ashkenazim. You're going to get a guy from, you know, from Russia and a guy from Tunisia. It's a different mindset. You have to have different types of Hachamim that know how to address their concerns and how to speak to them in a way that they will look upon favorably. המדוכה הזו ישבתי שנים רבות מיום עלייתי לארץ וראיתי שכל מערכת הדיינים מורכבת כולה מאשכנזים לבד. פרט לשלושה דיינים ספרדים ששובסו במערכת למראית עין. It was really, this is a big problem, this Ashkenazi Sephardi thing, and it bothered me from the day I made Aliyah to Israel. And I saw every grouping, every line of judges, of Dayanim, all consisted of all Ashkenazim, except for three Sephardi Dayanim. They were put there only for looks. Just for looks. Sephardim are there, so we could say we have Sephardim there. Shekol ahad mehim haya batel barob. Okay? They're null and void. They're batel barob. Lo yitachen. This cannot be. Sa'achti ladayyan ashkenazi lared lesof da'ato shel dayyan Sephardim. I yelled at Ashkenazi dayyan, get down and try to understand the mindset of the Sephardi dayyan. Look at him like a person. Look at him as an equal. Discuss it. Look at it. Ki eino mesugal adat et ofiyam b'nahagotam b'tanei hayayim. You don't know the mindset of the people. You don't know the way they think. You don't know the way they act. You don't know the way they live in their house. You don't know the way they talk. You don't know the way they grew up. Ve'ech yasliach ladun bin ish v'ishto b'sedek. How can you, an Ashkenazi judge, now come and deal with a Sephardi husband and wife that are having an issue? How are you going to talk to them? How are you going to relate to them? You cannot do it. And the dayan is tied to the Shulchan Aruch, and you cannot differentiate not to the right, not to the left. Ki halakha eina b'hina bin Ashkenazi lebin Sephardi. But halakha does not differentiate between Ashkenazi and Sephardi. Yeshnam debarim hatiluim b'shikul da'ato shel hadayan. But there are many things that left up to the common sense, up to the experience and knowledge and know-how of the dayan. B'vaday sh'tiyeh da'ato noteh lebin adato. So somebody who comes from the same community, from the same mindset, obviously he's going to know how to deal with it differently. U'b'netiyah mu'aytet alul hishtanut hadin. But if you bring a guy from Ethiopia to go and judge a guy from Germany, you can't do it. You're going to bring a guy from New Hampshire, for example. You bring a... We'll go to Mississippi. And you bring a KKK guy from Mississippi to judge a black guy from Georgia. What do you think is going to happen? He's not going to understand him. He's not going to care to understand him.
String him up.
במיוחד כאשר הזוג מעורב אישה אשכנזית ואיש ספרדי או להפך. And then if you have mixed marriage of אשכנזי and ספרדי, you know, there's a lot of different issues that come up. How are you going to deal with it? שאז אם מתחייב ספרדי יחשוב שהייתה כאן תהיה עדתית. Right? So if you can have a ספרדי judge for a mixed marriage couple, you went with the husband because it's also ספרדי against me. Or if you have just אשכנזי judge, it's going to be, you know, neither side is going to feel that it's 100% fair if you don't have the right mixture, the right balance. שאז אם מתחייב ספרדי יחשוב שהייתה כאן תהיה עדתי והתורה אמרה והייתם נקיים מהשם מישראל ורק עם מנוייו של אהרון אבו חסירה لسر هدأتوت. Only when Aharon Abu Haseira was appointed as minister of religion, Shoreha Masab Kisal Etuba. Only then did I start to see things changed a little bit for the better. I don't know. I never heard his name before. هو إخنيس كما ديانيم سعيريم سفرادي لمعاريخ ذو شهيا سيغورا بفنهم سيغيرا هرماتي. He was the first one who put in a few young Sefaradi Dayanim into this lineup of Dayanim that until that point was completely closed. You could not get in. בכל זאת עדיין דיינים ספרדים מהווים רק שליש מכל המערכת. And still, until today, you know, most the Sefaradi Dayanim are only a third of any lineup of Dayanim, he's telling you. Now, I find this interesting because we know Rabbi Ma'akob Moshe Toledano was minister of religion. He passed away in 1960. So I don't know, you know, what was going on at his time. Mubad Me'ilev. He's coming to his conclusion now. Shegam b'ma'arechet rabbanut yesorech l'shnei rabbanim b'chol a'ir. Bottom line is we still need two chief rabbis. Ashkenazim Sefaradi. Shekein tefkido shel rab makom hu la'anot al she'elot isur v'heter. The job of the rabbi is to answer on questions of isur v'heter. In other words, we're talking about issues pertaining to yoredi'a of meat and milk and shahita, etc. Lehadrich et somar aito adrichei ha-Torah v'hira, to direct and teach the people in the ways of the Torah and the fear. Lehashgiach al kashrut, to watch over the kashrut. Urot la'am ma ya'aseh Yisrael, to teach them halakha. Liyot sheyishnam debarim rabbim. And since we all know there are many differences in customs between Ashkenazim and Sefaradim, they each group needs, those are the two main groups, Sefaradim and Ashkenazim, they each one needs a main rabbi, a main figure to lead them and to help them. עד אשר יערה עלינו יברך שמו רוח ממרום ונתאחד ונתקד עם אחד. Until בורא עולם puts that spirit among us that we know how to unite into one real nation. We're not up to that point yet. ולא יזכר עוד שם אשכנזי ולא שם ספרדי. And at that point, these appellations of ספרדי and אשכנזים will no longer be known. They won't be used. אלא ישראלי בן אברהם יצחק ויעקב. Everybody's going to be considered. You know, bottom line, student of Yishak, a child of Yishak, Abraham Yishak Yaakov. Kishnei la'am ehab, tihye lanu Torah ahat, mishpat ahad. This is what we want, because this is what we're looking for. We want to be one nation, one Torah, one law. Yat'im lanu rabbi ahad. And then at that point, we're going to have just one rabbi. Zohi tikvatin. This is our hope, this is our aspiration. Sheyagiya hazeman. שבו יהיה אדוני לימין אחד כל הארץ והיה אדוני אחד ושבו אחד בעגלה בזמן קריב אמן. Beautiful תשובה. He dealt with the issues in a very clear, simple fashion without any casuistry. You know, simple.
Simple.
Simple. True.
And sensible too.
Sensible because he believes in the Torah. And so he sees it.
No. But he's also realistic.
He's very realistic. Yeah. So we're going to look at two short letters that deal with similar issues. Yoreno Moreno Harab Shalita. Haim lo higia bizzaman. Ahare 40 shana shal geulata al batel et kol haminhagim ha'adatiyim manushaot shal tefillah. Says, Rabbi, we have a state now for 40 years. Okay? So we're on now. It's 1988. Okay? Isn't it about time that we stop all the different minhagim of the different communities and stop all these different versions, textual differences in the prayers? Should we just make one form of prayer, one form of minhag for all of the citizens of the state so we could, you know, basically bring everybody together? And to forget about this mindset of the galut. Let's become one. As long as we keep these differences up, we can never become one unit. شكان شنوي زي من سياحة بيرود بمبليت تكاف مفريد بين أحيم. So basically the question is not much different than the previous question that we read. And he answered, obviously, I'm sure the answer is going to be almost the same, but much shorter, obviously, over here. Teshuba. Here's the answer. Da'ad yecha abrich yakar. So we know, obviously, the writer is a Kollel student. Okay, a young man.
How do we know that?
From the word abrich.
Okay.
That's generally the term used for these young guys learning Kollel. شئين هبدليها من هاجين بن هايدود بلوشينوها ملبوشين بما خليم بقعين بعدود عام may show difference من هاجين of the communities or the different clothing or the different food. That's not what's stopping unity among the nation. قام لوشينوها أوفي بهالديبور قولين بلو not even the style and the way we talk. كيم هداد ذا المنابل وهي إسرائيل هشليت بعام Bottom line is if you have imuna, if you have Torah, everything is together. Because what kept us together as a Jewish nation, even though we were separated all over the globe, you know, for countless centuries, was what? Was Torah. And that's how Jews knew that there were Jews in this corner of the earth and Jews in that corner of the earth, and they had Torah journals, you know, where different Jews from all parts of the earth wrote into the same journal, and people would read. The guy from Morocco would read, the guy from Poland, the guy from Russia would read, the guy from Syria, the guy, you know, from Egypt would read, the guy from Turkey, and, you know, whatever the case may be. No problem. Nikla Adam Mirusia Ome Polonia and Morocco, the Surfa, Chone Besuratom Bushor, Be Ofav. تخنوتها أفلو بالسفاتو كاخ شين إي شوريا ما هو ساح إم هو مصطيع لأخي جهدوتو هو متكبر بزرعات بتوحات كأحد أحيم وإن قلوتها مشنويم حيسونيم مشنيم إتيا حسك الباب. Bottom line is he didn't say anything different here than he said before, but basically this guy's a kid, let me just give him a quick answer. The previous writer was a rabbi, I gave him a better answer. This guy's, you know, a kid, let me give him a simple answer. He didn't say anything different. We know it all. Let's look at the next one though. Next one's a little more interesting. Sheila Bahur Yeshiva. Bezema Sha'aniti though. Question that I got from Bahur Yeshiva, and here's my answer to him. Abrech Yakar. Again, see? Abrech Yakar. Student. Atashu'il. Imiye makom likboa nosach tefillah ahid lechol toshbeha medina. היות וכל קיבוצה של עולים חדשים קובעים לעצמה נוסח מסוים כפי שהייתה נוהגת בחוץ לארץ, כך נוסר מין פסיפס משונה של נוסח תפילות לא ראי זה כראי זה ואתה שואל. But bottom line, you ask me, can we make one form of prayer for everybody? Because every time another group makes aliyah, we have another synagogue, we have another form of praying, this guy prints another book, you know. In other words, you look in the mirror, supposed to see the same image in the mirror every time you look at it. But no, this is a mirror of Jews. Every single time I walk through, we see something else. You know, we're not one nation. Hey, miyesh makom lekboa nosa ayhayid betfilah bechol medina o shekol aydat shmor al nusha harigila ba. Can we make one version, or should everybody upkeep their versions? Im efshar v'itachin lekboa nosa ayhayid him yiyeh murkab me'otan nusha'ot hakidumot. And if we can make one version, is it going to be made up of ancient versions, or is it going to be something totally new? In the interim, like Marky was talking before about, you have different people from different communities within one synagogue. He goes, what nosach should they pray? What should they be doing over there? ראיתי ישיבה ספרדית, שלא שישיבה אשכנזי. ספרדי ישיבה, הנהדה אשכנזי, ראש ישיבה. והוא מכריח האברכי להתפלל בראש האשכנזי. האם זה נכון? And he's forcing the students to pray in אשכנזי style. Is that correct? יחידים ספרדים שנקלעו לבית כנסת אשכנזי, או להפך, איך התפללו. Yeah, Sephardi individuals that became part of the membership of Ashkenazi synagogue, or vice versa. What version should these individuals pray in? Sephardi or Ashkenazi? thought you were going to like this one. Teshuvah. So he's going to answer the question not exactly in order now. Teshuvah. Ashad al-Sha'ila Gimel. Okay, in other words, what should different people in one synagogue be doing?
It's interesting how he took that one first.
Because it's...
maybe the most important one?
Not the most important. It's maybe not the simplest one, but it's the most common one, I think.
We're going to build on it.
Probably. Nosah hatefillah. Vada yiyye miha'idah mihaveh rob. Bottom line is, majority rules. If the majority of the kiddies is from Syria, pray Syrian style. If the majority of the kiddies is from Morocco, pray Moroccan style. Moroccan, whatever the majority is, that's the way you're praying over there. Ba'al she'ela ribi'id, and on the fourth question about this Ashkenazi Rosh Hashiva for a Sephardi Yeshiva, Haddavar Pashut Sherosh Hashiva Oseh Sheloke Hogan. Bottom line is, this Rosh Hashiva is not conducting himself properly. וזכור אני שלפני כמה שנים נלוויתי להרב הגאון הראשון לסיון, הגאון עובדיה יוסף פליטה, בביקורו בבית ספר בעפולה. He goes, and I remember well, this happened a number of years ago. I was accompanying the chief rabbi, Rabbi עובדיה יוסף, when he was visiting a school in עפולה. והוכיח למרסות את מנהל בית ספר בנוכחות ראש העיר, על השם מלמד תלמידים ספרדים כיסו שחרנות אשכנזי ומלמדם להתפלל בראש אשכנזי במקום ראש ספרדי. That he went to town. He shambled the principal of the synagogue in the presence of the mayor of the city that he was teaching Sephardi students כיסו שחרנות, which is an Ashkenazi book, right? Rabbi Shlomo Gansfried. Okay, which is not halacha for Sephardim. And he was teaching them to pray in Nosach Ashkenazi instead of Nosach Sephardi. He went to town on him.
This is in the school, not in the Knesset.
Right, in the school.
Yeah.
Okay. But he did it in front of the mayor of the city. He shambled the principal in front of the mayor. Go. So that should answer your question. Yeah, about that. Other she'ila hamishit. Okay, the fifth question that we said is that Sephardim individuals in Ashkenazi synagogue or vice versa. Im yesh lahem minyan mishlahem, yitpallu benosach shelahem. If they have their own minyan, let them pray their own way. Im lo, but if not, ya'anu kaddish u'kdusha im ha-sibur ve'yitpallu la'asmam. The things that they have to do out loud, let them do like the sibur. So you don't make division within the synagogue. And the things that they're praying quietly, they can pray their own way. So in other words, you get to, you're a Sephardi and Ashkenazi Knis, they don't say Nakdishaf and Anisaf, right? They say Nakadish Shemaf Ulama.
Right. Okay? I did Kaddish.
Right, you do it there. So you would answer Kiddusha their way, or you're doing Kaddish, you do Kaddish their way, where they're missing one Amen. Okay? You do it their way. But the things that you're praying privately, pray, you know, pray it in your order privately, the way you would normally do it. Now let's get to the first two questions. Halalu dorshot bikiut v'rikuz ma'hashava b'chdei l'anot alehim. Need to really focus on these questions, he's telling you, to answer them properly. Uma gam shliyot v'hashelot hen kelaliyot. And since these questions are general questions concerning the entire nation practically, there is no individual that has the right to answer them.
So he's saying he doesn't want to answer them?
See, you can't.
Oh, I see.
So you can't answer it. You know, because as an individual, you're going to want to do what's good for you. You have to be part of a group. You know, to do this. A large group, obviously. Ana samkhut lishum yahid lishum alayhim. Pirat l'rabbanut harashit shehi hasamkhut ha'ayuna. Except for the chief rabbinate, which would have the highest authority for such a thing. V'rakhi reshait l'anut alayhim. And only it can answer it. V'ulay yisorech kenis rabbani olami. And maybe we even need to have a worldwide gathering of rabbis. From the entire world, from within Israel and outside. شي يسافي يتم بتارونها بعياء ومي ودي عم يخلها جيا لدرس كما so they could deal with the ins and outs of the back and forth of this question and who knows if they'll ever be able to reach an agreement زخوتي שבשנת תשכח because I had the privilege in the year 1968 התקיים כנס רבני עולמי בהיכל שלום בירושלים he referred to this before, he didn't tell us what year
right.
now you know it's 1968 על ידי המנוח דוקטור יפה Okay, this was arranged by Dr. Yefe. I don't know who he was, but probably somebody important in the government or Ministry of Religion or something. And one of the rabbis brought up this problem. We need to form one way of praying, you know, that all the communities can use. And Rabbi Unterman came out against him. בנאום חריף ותקיף נגד שינוי המנהגים. He came at him with a knife, basically. There's no way you could start changing מנהגים. ובו קבע, and he established, בסורה ברורה, in a very clear fashion, שכל עדה חייבת לשמור על מנהגיה. Every community must adhere to its customs. והנוסח התפילות הרגיל ישראל. And to the format of praying that it's used to. ולא היה שם מי שיערער על דבריו. And there was nobody there that was able to counter him.
Is it Unterman guy?
Rabbi Unterman. Okay. He was the chief Ashkenazi rabbi of Israel at the time. Okay. והדין עמו. And now Rabbi Malka is saying, yes, he is right. Law, you know, the law is with him. כי כידוע, as is known, עיקר התפילה היא הכוונה. What's the main point of תפילה? It's kavana, it's the intention, it's the thought. ותפילה בלי כוונה היא כגוף בלי נשמה. And if you pray without any thought, without any intention, without any focus, you're like a body without a soul. You're a zombie. Okay? כמו שכתב הרמב״ם. כל, this is הלכה דלת, הלכות תפילה, it's probably פרק דלת, הלכות תפילה הלכה תדבב. כל תפילה שאינה בכוונה אינה תפילה ואם יתפלל בלי כוונה חוזר ומתפלל בכוונה and if you pray without כוונה you have to go back and repeat your prayer pray again with כוונה והנה כידוע שלכל קהילה יש לו נוסח מיוחד וניגון מסוים וכשהסדר או הניגון משתנה הכוונה נעלמת every community has its way of praying its tune its style okay its nuances And if that's not there, you lose focus. When the hazan is off, you can't pray properly. The same thing. And if now all of a sudden the kavanah disappears, the alimah disappears, and the prayer, the person that is praying, gets confused. He gets flustered. It's not only the words that establish your focus and your chain of thought. But it's also the tune and the notes that are familiar to you going back. That's what channels you the right path.